We are going to discuss the network connecting devices, that is routers. A router is a three-layer device that routes packets based on their logical addresses, that is host-to-host addressing. And normally to connect LANs and WANs, the routers are used in the internet and has a routing table that is used for making decisions about the route. So as the router is working up to the network layer, so below that we are having the data link layer, below that we are having the physical layer, so it is up to working to the third layer in that case, so it is also known as three-layer device. And as it is working in the third layer, so it can take the routing decisions, because this particular network layer is having that property, is having the task to get performed, that is the routing decisions taking. So this particular router will be better than this bridges, because bridge could do only the filtering of packets, but there is no scope was for bridge to do the routing, but this routing can be done using these routers. And routers are used in the internet and has a routing table that is used for making decisions about the route. These routing tables are formed normally dynamically and are updated using routing protocols. So there are multiple different routing protocols with the help of which this router routing table will get updated. And dynamically this routing table will be created. You might be asking me that why it has to be created in dynamic way. Dynamically it will be created because different routes may have different congestion level at different time intervals. So as a result of that, as along with time, sometimes the congestion will be increasing in a certain route, sometimes it will be decreasing, so it is time variant. So obviously a route which is preferable right now may not remain preferable in the next time period. So that's why this routing table will be created in a dynamic way. In the diagram, routers connecting independent LANs and WANs that has been shown here, you can find that LANs are connected with this particular router, there is another LAN is connected to the rest of the internet, and there is the two routers are working and they are working in between. So in this way, what is the router and what are the basic functionalities of the router, we have shown you, but how these routing tables are getting formed and how this dynamic way, the way to create the routing tables, we are having other videos, there will be discussing all these respective topics. And thanks for watching this.
Tutorialspoint.com. Simply easy learning.